For those of you who watched Last Week Tonight on Sunday, you had the privilege of watching John Oliver destroy Donald Trump for about 20 solid minutes. He successfully exposed many of Trump's lies and mischaracterizations, but perhaps the best result of this segment was the creation of the Drumpfinator. So obviously this has been blowing up in social media over the past couple of days, and in my opinion, with good reason, but you know, that's just me. So a couple of, if you didn't see it, a couple of the things that happened in this segment was John Oliver kind of, you know, discussed a few of the fallacies surrounding Trump's candidacy and just him as a person. But the one of the funniest things that happened was it was revealed that a family member in Trump's family from the past, they actually changed the name from the original name, Drumpf, D-R-U-M-P-F, to Trump, right? So that's kind of what led to all of this Drumpfinator stuff. So they, the Last Week Tonight folks, they got the URL DonaldJDrumpf.com. They're marketing hats that say make Donald Drumpf again. But the pièce de résistance of this is the Drumpfinator, which is a Chrome extension that basically allows you to change Trump anytime you see it in your web browser to Drumpf, which is, you know, it's
genius.
Ripe for fodder, of course. What I found very interesting, though, is waking up today, apparently over 4 million downloads of this Chrome extension have occurred. And also, if you go to Google and type in make, the first thing that comes up is make Donald Drumpf again. And it's the number one trending subreddit, Donald Drumpf.
Wow, that's really cool. And you know, John Oliver and his people collectively, they do a great job of finding little things that are kind of silly and just stretching them out and blowing them up. Mm-hmm. So like, that's genius on their part, the way they went about this, and I love it. Always a funny guy. But the question is whether or not this is going to make any sort of impact or not. I mean, are Donald Trump supporters, for example, going to get put off by the fact that his last name used to be Drumpf?
Right.
Which is like the most disgusting word I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah.
But I don't know, if you know, getting an endorsement from white supremacists and a former KKK leader isn't enough to put you off, something like this probably won't either. And at the end of the day, we can't forget, Donald Trump's not going to go after this. It's Super Tuesday. He's got bigger fish to fry.
Yeah, well, I mean, if anything, it just kind of speaks to the power of comedy, or that, you know, I mean, Jon Stewart was doing stuff like this all before. I mean, this is kind of it's a little bit different. But if anything, I find it just fascinating. But no, I certainly don't think that Trump supporters are going to be like, dang, his name is Drumpf? Well, geez, I guess I've been wrong this whole time. I do find it interesting that Trump hasn't said anything about it, just because he generally is the first to go after anybody that criticizes him in any way by just being like, you're a loser. But
maybe
I don't
want to draw more attention to something that's like real and true. Like, usually the things that he tweets out or goes after is like some bogus facts put out by some white supremacist, or he's misquoting Gandhi or something.
But his ego, like, that's the only thing. Is I'm like, has he learned now that you should just ignore people? You know, because he hasn't been doing that at any time
and
before.
And the fact that, what does that say that John Oliver's even going after him right now?
Yeah.
It's like, kind of like, well, it's kind of worrying, because at the beginning he was a joke, and then he became like this really scary racist joke, mm-hmm. and then he became like this, oh my God, he's sweeping all the states joke, which isn't a joke anymore. Now it's worse.
And on the show, John Oliver basically refers to Donald Trump as like a mole that used to be pretty benign or innocuous, but then you're like, oh, I got to get this checked out. So I think that's why he went after him. Either way, we'll see how it plays out. I can't imagine that anybody that is an avid Trump supporter is really going to change their tune. But for me, in the meantime, let's continue to make Donald Drumpf again.